My favorite medium is vinyl, being tape and vinyl itself, because that is the essence of, if you look at the way music's recorded in the past, of how it was so great, was on tape. That's how everything is pretty much comes down. You can do it digitally in bits, but vinyl has that, all the nuances, all the problems, all the detail is in that. And you basically, by listening to it that way, it's like sucking it out and you hear everything. And it puts you in that mood, in the place, the time, and it makes you think about how that music was created.
My favorite way to listen to music is definitely as loud as I can stand it. And I love listening to live CDs, live albums, and especially in my car. And I think a lot of musicians will tell you they listen to their music in their cars, because I can really turn it up loud to the volume. I really like it. And except when I drive my convertible, because my mailman can hear me 3 blocks away. But I think I like that the best, and that would be a DVD, you know, through just my stereo system in the car.
All my friends always, I had the best stereo at the time, so they always want to come to my house and bring their records, etc. Even back then, I was always kind of a social musical host, if you will. And then also, in addition, always playing in bands, so that was kind of, you know, went dovetailed with that. People would come out and watch me perform.
So listening parties, when I was doing them, basically I would, friends, you tell them to come over on a Saturday so everybody's off work. We have a barbecue and everybody would bring, you know, carne asada, whatever, and then have beers and stuff like that. And he would sit down and listen to, I would have 3 different systems. And my goal was to show people or friends what it sounded like, or what the rarest of rare, or something new that I've created that I think is different. And everybody would critique it and sit down and listen to music and just say, wow, this is pretty cool.
The listening parties then have evolved over until like currently what they typically are, or listen to a lot of surround sound DVDs. I look for well-recorded master audio DTS codecs on the DVDs so that I know they'll sound good. And then a lot of my friends have their own as well, and they bring them over. So a lot of after parties with a lot of people over my house, and sometimes even not, when we just will get together, somebody gets a new DVD and want to bring it over. So anywhere from 2 or 3 people, occasionally 2, as many as 25 or so.
And they just sit down, they go, I like the horns, and then they go to the next room and listen to a set of electrostats. They go, oh, I like that too, and you can see how they jump back and forth. By listening to a good system, your ear gets educated. And it's hard to go back to something like a little pocket radio after you listen to a good system, because that's always in your mind. And that's the spark that sparks an audiophile. It's like the first time they sat down into a room and listened to a set of big Altec speakers.
Always another element of it was, if I couldn't afford, or time-wise, or had a gig and couldn't go to a show that was coming to town, let's say Tom Petty or somebody was coming to town and I wanted to go to the show, I would, to appease myself, I would buy a DVD or the new CD and then crank it, and that would be my experience in lieu of going to the show.
It's taken me a couple years to get the sound the way I like it, but it sounds most likely as if you were listening to them in concert, and that's how I like to hear it, and I like to hear it with the mistakes left in. Not this Zeppelin stuff where they take out the mistakes, but like get your yayas out, the Stones. You can definitely pick up the mistakes, and it's the beauty of it.